Hey guys, it's Adonai96, and welcome to the 21st video in the Spanish Chronicles. So, here I am, going to recruit, some more gorillas. And I decided that, gorillas were actually one of Spain's main strengths. So I'm actually going to use a lot of them, just to, at least in the early stages of this game. Because although they have bad morale, they have a longer range than line infantry, as you all know, and they only cost 300 monies, or whatever it's measured in. So I just decided to make the most of it, even if I had previously said they were bad. Now that they have their decreased cost due to the patches or whatever, I am going to start buying more of them. But, here, we might be ready for an offensive into Georgia, but the thing is, they have occupied some areas that were previously in the 13 colonies, and they actually have a pretty significant empire here, as you see, 5 regions. So I'm worried if I attack into Georgia, I'll expose another flank or something that I can't defend, and I'll sort of get enveloped as I advance. And that's not what I want. We're gonna tax the Dutch there again, because we need the money. Even though it'll make them unhappy, they can suffer. So those Moroccans are kind of being annoying, but I do not think they're brave enough to move up towards Madrid any further than they've gone before. And soon, hopefully, Portugal will fall, and then it'll start looking, pretty bad for the Moroccans. So I see a lot of the Cherokee troops are moving away from Georgia, which makes it look like I want to invade, but here we can intercept, and I'm actually going to choose to do this, and that way the computer will be faced with the retarded scenario of having to be intercepted by a fortress. That's what they get. Anyway, I skipped the deployment phase. Well, I skipped showing it to you. I still deployed everything. Because it was just a pretty basic way I had it. There's no surprises or anything. I basically just spread out all my different infantry on the walls, and so they could man all the cannons. And I just think pikemen should be able to go on the walls just so they can, you know, for melee, and they should be able to operate cannons as well. Also, I've just been kind of wondering, it seems that they've been doing a lot of patches, and that's good, but I'm wondering how they figure out what needs patching. Do they actually, like, listen to what the players have to say? And do they sometimes watch, like, even videos about the game? I do not really know. But one time, it was a while ago, back before Empire was released, I was looking at Medieval 2 Total War videos. and I forget his name, something on YouTube, but he had a video of Medieval 2 Total War, and he found like a bunch of really smart things that they could fix. And I don't know, I just thought it was cool how he looked so in depth into the game. And he had some really good suggestions. So I'm moving my infantry from the rear up so that we can just shoot at them more before they can get around all the way, and then we'll have to fall back as well. But it's kind of cool how they're all sort of like forming up. It's although there's lots of glitches in siege battles that I don't like, when it works nicely it is so fun to watch and play. And this is basically going to be like one of those battles. It's not going to be glitched up, which is good. And the reason I decided to kill the rebels instead of just let them roam around and kill an invading army if they can is because if I kill them I can sorry, I'm out of it right now. Okay, here we go. If I beat their army and like I kill the rebels, then there's less unhappiness in Amsterdam, which makes it easier to control, and also they'll stop going around and raiding all my different farms and things, which is annoying and hurts my production. So anyway, we're forming up and we're gonna kill some Dutch people. Put our bayonets in. We actually should be almost done researching the next type of bayonets. Gonna spread their line out a little. Well, we're gonna send it over so they can make use of those cannons there. The cannons aren't that strong, but it's recommended that you use them, so they're definitely there for a reason. They do help a little bit, and they probably do some morale damage, which is... I think it would be more important than killing them, considering they're not so good at actually killing the enemy. But, actually nothing. Anyway, we've routed their one regiment that attacked in the front, and we're having to move around to the back, because that's how most of them are going. But they have one regiment left that is moving towards me, and this regiment of militia has their bayonets equipped, so we are not going to actually be able to use the cannons even. We're just going to have to wait for them to climb the walls, and then we'll kill them. Oh well. Also, you get like an important fortifications bonus when you're defending, and that's why my regiment of militia, well, among other reasons, was able to kill theirs so easily. Also, it's because we're killing them as they come up the wall, so it's like one of them versus like being surrounded by all of my guys at any one time when they come up. Which, like in Medieval 2 Total War, we're relating a lot of things to that, I guess, in this episode, but it was siege ladders versus towers, and they both have different advantages, but one of the siege towers' advantage over the ladders is that the towers, when they open up on top of the walls, the men can just swarm out and immediately like hold a little bit of ground on the wall instead of just being able to be killed instantly when they come up to the top of the ladders. They sort of have numbers on their side. It's not a trickle. But then again, ladders are incredibly hard to hit with fire arrows. Anyway, we got them routing on multiple sides of the base. I don't know if you heard what I just said, I had the mic away from my mouth a little bit, but anyway, I was saying how we routed them on multiple sides of the base. You might have... I don't know. Thank you.
Infanteria a la orden.